we are preparing a slider here. So this is the header comment that we have provided over here. It is indicating, it is suggesting what kind of component we are about to create into our project. So this is the first thing that we have created. Now inside, all we are going to do, so in the first case, we will be creating here now here comes the anomaly. In the very first case, instead of creating the container class, we have created a main wrapper class over here. So why so? In order to get 100% width, the very first thing that we are going to do, we are going to create a particular selector class which is indicating to 100% width. So that is why we are creating a custom style property. We are practically involving some custom properties into our project, and that is why we have used this individual class of div class main wrapper over here instead of using this container class. Now if for the time being, let's get to Google and we are typing as carousel slider materialize. There it goes, carousel materialize. Let's open it into a new tab. So this is that carousel that we are practically talking about, and we can see that all those codes, those are practically been provided over here. If we want to use this individual slider here, this is the first slider. So if we want to use them into our project, all we are first going to do, we are going to copy it. Now get back to your project. In the second case, all we are going to do, we are going to place our slider into a separate class which is known as slider holder. So this is the main wrapper which is practically wrapping both these elements over here, this slider and this menu bar. This is the purpose of this individual class element here, main wrapper. And inside this main wrapper, we are practically wrapping up our slider content or slider element into another individual class, which is known as slider holder. Now let's get back to our project. And in the very first case, all we are going to do, we are going to paste them into our project. Now, leaving it up to this, if we get back to our project and reload, we will see that practically nothing happened. No slider is being visible over here. This is why we need to get back to the carousel slider site. And here we will be seeing that this is the initialization. So we can do it with the aid of JavaScript. And if we use that in this case, we may caught into some uncaught reference error, which is not desirable. So according to theory, it is much better to work with the jQuery. That means we are initializing our carousel components with the aid of this jQuery. All we need to do, we need to copy them and we need to get back to our project. And we are pasting, sorry, first of all, put this thing into script, and into this particular script, we are going to paste them over here. Now, if we get back to our project and reload, we will now see that the slider is back into its action. We can see that each and every of these components, those are being used over here. And in this case, I would like to remind you that I haven't used any kind of customized images. So far, all we are using their code and their images. Now, if we get back to our project, so this is the type 1 slider that we are practically using over here. Now in the second case, if we move on to this materialize CSS slider, we can see that this is the full width slider, and there goes the code. this is the code to this deep class carousel slider. We are practically using this full scale slider over here. So in the second case, if we just get back and copy them and get back to our project, and so far we are deleting this thing and we are pasting it over here. So this is the code that we have copied from their project. Now if we press Ctrl S and get back to our project and reload, we will see that this will be the result. Remember that so far we haven't provided any kind of custom specification of ours, and this is the first thing. And in the second case, we are practically using their own images that we do not practically own, so we need to change all these images. But before that, we need to see whether these things are working or not. There it goes, it is working. Now if we get back to our project, first of all, we need to make these amendments over here. We do not wish to use this kind of images. That is why these are the images, those we are going to use practically into our project. We are going to use all these images, and this is individually under this images folder over here. So the folder name, we know the drill very well. First of all, let's specify the folder name. Then all we are going to do, this is the file name. Let's assume that we are using this file name over here, 1.jpg. We are going to copy this thing from here and we are going to paste it. First of all, paste all of them. This is the second image, third image, fourth, fifth, sixth. So we'll be using this fourth, fifth, and sixth image over here, which is 4, then it goes 5, then it goes 6. Press Ctrl S, get back to your project and reload. Images are not working over here, so we need to rectify that, the error that we have done, we have provided over here. So there it goes. This is the first slider that we are using. This is the second slider, the third one, and the fourth one. But still we can see that there are some discrepancies out there. So we need to customize this slider right now. We need to customize them in accordance to our project, in accordance to our need. For say, we are practically wanting all those images to appear, to practically occupy this whole document over here, this whole HTML browser that we are currently viewing, or at least instead 92% or 90% of this total browser width, browser height. So in that case, what do we need to do additionally? This is the thing that we are going to discuss now. Observe them till the end.